Good morning. How are you all? I hope you've been keeping well and are managing to cope with our new life way of life, which has virtually become our new normal for now. Let us come together as we pray for God's blessings over us this morning. Thank you so much, Father God, for the joy of your presence with us, that wherever we are, you are right there too, right by our side, ready to help and guide us, and only a prayer away. We love you and pray your blessings upon us, and thank you deeply for the ways in which you help us and lead us through times of fear, as with this coronavirus, and in other areas of difficulties and trials we face. Thank you for the joy of each new day and for the opportunities you give us to love and encourage our families and friends. Please open our hearts and our minds to hear your message for us today. In Jesus' name we ask this. Amen. Our scripture reading for this morning I've taken from that well-known passage of Jesus walking on the water. To put it in context, immediately after Jesus had fed the 5,000, he dismissed them and made the disciples get into their boat and go ahead of him while he went up on the mountainside alone to pray. When evening came, that boat was far out at sea, being tossed about by violent winds and waves. And we read now from Matthew chapter 14, verses 25 to 33. During the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went out to them, walking on the lake. When the disciples saw him walking on the lake, they were terrified. "It's a ghost," they said, and cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, "Take courage, it is I, don't be afraid." "Lord, if it's you," Peter replied, "tell me to come to you on the water." "Come," he said. Then Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, and came towards Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid, and beginning to sink, cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. "You of little faith," he said, "why did you doubt?" And when they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Then those who were in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." Now, according to a commentator, it was love which prompted Jesus to send his disciples on ahead of him into this trial so that he might follow and bring them through it. And this is what Jesus always does, sooner or later. He waits to be gracious. He knows the best time and he waits for that time. You can imagine what the disciples in their fear must have been thinking. "Why did he send us out? Why didn't he come with us? This is all his fault. He knew the weather might turn bad." And then in the fourth watch of the night, that's between 3 a.m. and 6 a.m., Jesus went out to them, walking on the water. The disciples had never seen anything like this, so no wonder they cried out in fear, "It's a ghost!" And their cries of fear led Jesus to speak. And he said, "Take courage, it is I, don't be afraid." The very sight of Jesus drew Peter to him. He wanted to be with Jesus. He knew he would feel safe with Jesus. And he did what each one of us should do. He first looked to Jesus. His eyes were fixed on Jesus. And for a moment, he forgot all danger. And then he would not venture without being called. So he said, "Lord, if it's you, tell me to come to you on the water." So he had noted that Jesus was really walking on the water. And when Jesus said, "Come," Peter stepped out of the boat and he walked on the water to go to Jesus. But then, when he saw the boisterous wind, that's when the moment of realization hit Peter and fear overwhelmed him. He sank, crying, "Lord, save me." What a short but meaningful prayer. Peter would have drowned had it not been for Jesus. Just think, those words, "Lord, save me," have brought Jesus to the rescue of thousands of sinking people around the world. And immediately Jesus stretched out his hand and caught Peter and said, "You of little faith, why did you doubt?" And as they stepped into the boat, the wild wind died down. So that wind was still raging till they got to the boat. But Peter did not sink again. And why? Because Jesus held him up. And Peter certainly wasn't going to let go of Jesus' hand. He had had enough of walking alone. Those first few steps between the boat and Jesus were quite enough to convince Peter of what would become of walking by himself. A few moments more and Peter would have sunk, but Jesus held Peter up. And that's what Jesus does for us in our times of fear and struggle, when we feel overwhelmed or find ourselves in deep water. He holds us up. Jesus shows us our helplessness when we're in that storm. He shows us where we cannot help ourselves, but he's able to come to us with his grace and power. Jesus knows our struggles and cares for us. As we look back on Peter's experience, there are three important things that he did. First, he looked to Jesus, and then he asked what God's will was in that situation. And once he knew God's will, he acted on it. He could have tied a rope round himself just in case, but he didn't. Jesus gave the word, and Peter acted on it. He trusted Jesus. And those in the boat who saw all this happening worshipped Jesus and said, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The wildest storm becomes calm in the presence of Jesus, because it's there where we find comfort, rest, and peace. Let us pray to our Almighty God. Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you for your love and faithfulness to us, for your promise that you will never leave or forsake us, that you will never leave us alone. We know that, like Peter, sometimes our faith may falter due to our circumstances. In those moments, O Lord, please help us to reach out to you, to hold onto your powerful hand, to release our fears to you, and to feel the power and the peace of your presence. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so, may God bless you and shine his face upon you and keep you safe. Bye for now.
In your